the Chief Executive Officer of Rwanda Development Board, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of His Excellency Paul Kagame, the President of the Republic of Rwanda, and the people of Rwanda, and on my own behalf, we are truly delighted today to welcome you all to this colorful opening ceremony of the Pan-African Festival, of the Pan-African Dance Festival, FESPAD, or in full, Festival Pan-African de la Danse. You may recall that our leaders adopted the Cultural Charter for Africa in 1976, which provided a sound framework for the promotion of Africa's cultural riches. The Cultural Charter also showed the level of interest and commitment of our leaders to the strengthening of the cultural diversity of Africa. The principal objectives of Cultural Charter were closely related to the overall aims and objectives of the Organization of the African Union, OAU, by that time, which was to promote the cultural integrity of the African people. Consequently, in 1998, OAU formed FESPAD. We are happy to know that the African Union Commission has continued in the proud tradition of promoting cultural integration of the African people and strongly supports Pan-African initiatives like FESPAD to promote people-to-people interaction. FESPAD certainly has strong potential to strengthen the African people's struggle against the social cultural conditions which prevent their development. Through the staging of events like FESPAD, our people can and indeed do assert their dignity and popularize their cultures. Indeed, through this festival, our people can overcome all forms of social exclusion by involving more talented people, particularly vulnerable groups, to express themselves through music and dance. The Constitutive Act of the African Union vests the mandate and obligation of the African Union to encourage and promote cultural cooperation among the African Union member states
to strengthen African unity. And the FESPAD has indeed consistently played an important role in promoting a better understanding among our peoples and countries in Africa. I encourage all the African countries to participate in the FESPAD. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, Rwanda is proud for being the permanent host for this event, which is held once every 2 years. And the Rwandan leadership and her people are very supportive of FESPAD and its cause, as it is one way of ensuring that Africa's cultures are promoted, respected, and enjoyed by all citizens. This is the 8th time Rwanda is hosting this event, which is a testimony that Rwanda is committed to promoting African identity, cultural plurality and diversity. The diversity of our African cultures has been providing and will continue to provide us with a vast amount of strength, hope, and inspiration in the rebuilding of the new peaceful, prosperous Africa. Rwanda has the willingness and capacity to host many more events of this kind. Culture, which is an integral part of FESPAD, has an important role to play in the reconciliation process, conflict resolution, and in building sustainable peace and security, especially in post-conflict situations in some other African countries. Culture can also play an important role in our search for African unity and a common humanity. Our common humanity as Africans lies in the diversity of our cultures. It is the total sum of all these cultures that premises our Africanness, which is being displayed here today. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, culture is inwardly manifested in our souls, language, beliefs, and value systems, and can be both negative and positive. We wish to reclaim our positive and constructive culture. As the continent strives to build peace, democracy, justice, and equity, we should not forget to discourage the harmful, negative cultural practices and to ensure that our cultures recognize the rights and dignity of all people, irrespective of gender, color, and beliefs. Culture is also outwardly manifested in our food, clothing, arts and craft. We have the most beautiful arts and craft that symbolize our African culture and values. We have our own beautiful music and dance that give meaning to our existence and our history. African artists speak, write, sing, and create what matters to us. Some of these are on display at this festival. And with a vision of enhancing the future role of culture in development and welfare, we should seek to strengthen education in the arts, not only to become better artists, but also to be better equipped with knowledge of our past. We need to do this for the sake of dialogue and to ensure that this culture is not lost to the future generations. We applaud artists for giving us knowledge and joy. We acknowledge that culture and the arts serve as an inspiration to many when dealing with difficult social context. But it must also be admitted that African artists do sometimes experience a feeling of frustration and despair due to the fact that their contributions to sustainable human and economic development advancement are not being accorded due recognition. African artists therefore need recognition and support to build their confidence and provide them with exposure and promotion. When people pursue careers in the arts, whether music, drama, dance, and visual arts, they want to be given recognition as we do with other professions. As a conclusion, culture and its expression in the arts, music, and dance are the very heart of our heritage, our democracy, our development, and our humanity. I would therefore appeal to you all present here today and to all Africans elsewhere, but within the continent and in the diaspora, to serve as cultural ambassadors for Africa and to play their respective roles in making our culture a strong pillar for Africa's development. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, dear participants, it's now my honor and privilege to declare the 8th Pan-African Dance Festival, FESPAD 2013, officially opened, and I wish you all great success. Thank you very much. May God bless you all.